Next, we will introduce a new function called the arccosecant. Let's recall the cosecant of x function and its graph. And let's answer the following questions. Is this function one-to-one? The answer is no, because it doesn't pass the horizontal line test. Does this function have an inverse? The answer is also no, because only one-to-one functions have inverses. Now, let's make a new function g of x from the cosecant of x by restricting the domain of the cosecant function to the interval between negative pi over 2 and pi over 2. Is this function one-to-one? The answer is yes, because it passes the horizontal line test. Does this function have an inverse? The answer is also yes, because all one-to-one functions have inverse functions. And here's what it looks like. What is this function? This function is not any of the functions that we already know, so we give it a name, the arccosecant of x function. Let's take a look at this new function and its graph. The domain of this function is all real numbers, except the values between negative 1 and 1. The range of this function is the values between negative pi over 2 and pi over 2, except 0. We should be able to find the output of this function for any input in the domain using the graph or a calculator. We introduced a new function called the arccosecant of x and discussed some of its properties.